What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to the Ajax Tottenham Champions League semi-final review and analysis video. And we just witnessed two of the greatest comebacks in Champions League history. Both semi-finals, a team from 3-0 down on aggregate made a comeback and won brilliantly, and Tottenham deserve a huge credit for this. But I think Ajax, it's a heartbreaking story because they were just like 10 seconds from getting to the Champions League final. So I commiserations to any Ajax fan watching this. I feel for you because I personally wanted Ajax to go to the final, and Ajax-Liverpool Champions League final would have sold such a sentimental and romantic value for me, because Ajax were a great team in the 80s and the 90s. They made many Champions League finals. Ajax are only one of, I think, two or three teams who won three Champions Leagues in a row, and Ajax have four Champions League trophies in a row. But I have to give a huge amount of credit to Tottenham and Mauricio Pochettino. Tottenham have been called butlers for many years, and Liverpool as well, by rival fans. So this is a huge vindication, and I think all the Arsenal fans will support Liverpool in the Champions League final. What a crazy timeline we are living in. And I think the reason why Tottenham could turn this around is that in the first half, Ajax pressed Tottenham high, and they couldn't really bypass the Tottenham high press. Even though Tottenham created some chances, the bigger chances fell to Ajax. They took two of them, and also in the second half, Tottenham changed tactics. That was the biggest reason, in my opinion, why Tottenham could make a comeback. They brought on Llorente, who is a tall striker, and they surrounded him with a lot of players, a lot of Tottenham players. So every time they bypassed the midfield and put the ball up to Llorente, there were Tottenham players to pick up the second ball. And I think that's huge. Also, what a crazy timeline. Lucas Moura was sold to Tottenham by Unai Emery, the current Arsenal manager at Paris Saint-Germain. And Lucas Moura just had the best game, the best second half of his life, scoring a hat-trick in a Champions League semi-final in one half is astonishing. But I think overall, if Ajax take more of their chances, they go to the Champions League final, because Dusan Tadic could have scored two or three goals today. Hakim Ziyech, he scored a brilliant goal, but he also hit the post, and he had another big chance which he narrowly missed by like this margin. If only one of those like four big chances go in, then Ajax make the final. Also, David Neres hit the post in the first leg, so Ajax can be desperately unlucky, but also maybe they showed a little bit of lack of experience, obviously, because Ajax are full of young players and a lack of know-how and maybe a little bit of a naivety. But still, I honestly think that Ajax did everything in the second half but score, and that was their downfall, because Tottenham could find a way to put three goals past Ajax. But also, it was a big mistake by Onana, the Ajax keeper. We have to talk about it. He grabs the ball before the second Tottenham goal, and then he grabs the ball, he wants to grab it to himself, but the ball hits his knee and then it bounces out, and Tottenham pick up the second ball, and somehow Lucas Moura finds a way between an Ajax defender's legs to shoot into the far corner. Huge credit to Lucas Moura, of course, but it was a big slice of luck, and that's, you need to get lucky sometimes in football. I think both Ajax and Tottenham deserve a huge amount of credit. They put on a magnificent showing. In the first half, Ajax were the better team. In the second half, it was more even. Tottenham came back into it, and maybe they were slightly the better team in the second half. But as I said, Ajax had two huge chances. Hakim Ziyech will be heartbroken, because even though he scored a goal in the Champions League semi-final, he should have had a hat-trick, honestly. I mean, Hakim Ziyech, he hits the post, and also he he misses with a in front of goal. He has a shot which he just goes narrowly wide, and it was heartbreaking for Ajax. I mean, Tottenham were hoofing the ball forward in the 95th minute, and there is an Ajax defender who slips, and if he doesn't slip, maybe he could clear the ball. And then De Ligt is this close to getting to Lucas Moura's shot, but in the end, Lucas Moura finds the bottom corner in the 96th minute. And incredible scenes. The Tottenham players were celebrating. Mauricio Pochettino crying on the pitch, on his knees, holding his head in his hands. And also in his post-match interview, Pochettino burst down in tears. Because this is vindication to Mauricio Pochettino for all the hard work. And all the doubters who said that Pochettino is a good manager, but he never won a trophy and Tottenham needs to win a trophy. Well, Jurgen Klopp and Pochettino, one of them will answer their critics big time by winning the Champions League. One of Liverpool and Tottenham, who many, many rival fans have been criticizing for playing good football but not having anything to show for it. And I think football shouldn't just be about winning trophies. Of course, a big club like Liverpool is about winning trophies, but this has been a very, very successful season for Liverpool, no matter what happens. And I think it has been a successful season for Tottenham as well. It's a historic season. This is, I think, Tottenham's first European Cup final, first Champions League final. One of them will end up with the trophy. And even if Tottenham lose the final, for example, you can't say that it's not a successful season for Tottenham, because this is honestly the best ever team probably that Tottenham have. And I think Tottenham will be a very, very dangerous opponent in the Champions League final, because they will have Harry Kane back, but both teams will have a good, like, almost 3 weeks rest and preparation time to prepare for the Champions League final. And we shouldn't underestimate Tottenham, because Tottenham had a very good, like, 25-30 minute spell at Anfield in the game where we beat them, where they could have scored 2 or 3 goals and actually came back into the game. So I think Liverpool need to take this very seriously. We are a better team than Tottenham overall, but not by a big margin. I would have been a little bit more confident against Ajax, even though Ajax have a great team, but Ajax are a lot more unpredictable. So you could see pros and cons on either side. I would have preferred Ajax mainly because of the style of football that they play, but Tottenham also play really, really good football. Tottenham will know Liverpool inside and out, and vice versa. Tottenham are finishing 24, 25 points behind Liverpool, and Liverpool have beaten Tottenham home and away in the Premier League. And in the away game, actually, we were much the better team against Tottenham. But you can't predict a Champions League final. In a one-off game, anything can happen. I'm not afraid of playing Tottenham. I'm afraid of losing to Tottenham, and also losing the full final for Jurgen Klopp would be devastating. It would have devastating consequences. So Liverpool must win this Champions League final. We must get a big reward for all our hard work that we did in this season. And I think Liverpool have been nothing short of magnificent in this season. I'm really proud of the team, of the players, of Jurgen Klopp. But now against Tottenham, we have to win the Champions League final. Otherwise, many people will say that Jurgen Klopp just can't win a final. And I think that it's not Jurgen Klopp's fault. For all 3 finals that we played, we weren't the favorites. Sevilla was the favorite when we played them in the Europa League. Remember that was a Liverpool team which finished in 8th place in the Premier League. It wasn't Jurgen Klopp's team. Jurgen Klopp came in halfway through the season. The second final, Manchester City in the League Cup. Manchester City were heavy favorites, but we only lost on penalties. The third final, Real Madrid. Real Madrid was massive favorites. They won 3 Champions Leagues in the previous 4 seasons. And we were desperately unlucky in that final. Our goalkeeper made two massive mistakes to gift Real Madrid the Champions League victory. Also, Mohamed Salah was substituted. And I think this is the key. Salah and Firmino will be back for the Champions League final and maybe even Oxlade-Chamberlain. So potentially the only player that Liverpool will miss in the Champions League final is Naby Keita. So Liverpool will be at their full strength team. And we must win that Champions League final. So yeah, let me know, guys, what do you think about this great comeback? Some people are saying that this comeback is better than the Liverpool comeback against Barcelona. I don't think so. I don't agree with that, because Tottenham were only one goal down before this game began. And yes, during the game they were 3-0 down on aggregate, but Ajax are nowhere near as good as the Barcelona team. So to come back against Barcelona from 3-0 down is I think a slightly better comeback than coming back against Ajax from 3-0 down. But this Tottenham comeback goes down as one of the top 5 or even one of the top 3 Champions League comebacks, alongside the Istanbul Champions League final comeback. I don't think that will be topped, because to come back in a final against one of the all-time great AC Milan teams, that was just an incredible achievement. But the Barcelona comeback, Liverpool comeback against Barcelona, and this comeback, the Tottenham comeback against Ajax, that is probably in the other two in the top 3 Champions League comebacks. And I'm just re-watching the highlights of the game. Llorente had a massive part to play in the winner for Tottenham, because it was a long ball to Llorente and he knocked it down, and Tottenham picked up the second ball and they scored through Lucas Moura. So that is a huge tactical change in the second half. But Ajax, they had this Champions League final in their hands. If Hakim Ziyech scores even one of these two chances, they go through to the final. So that's why it's heartbreaking for Ajax. But let me know what they think in the comments below. And thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. See you later, guys. Goodbye.